The buildings are on fire! It's a full-scale assault! But they've already abducted everyone! Why are they still attacking us?
Hey guys, it's Gabriella and welcome back to another scary text message story. Today we're going to be playing Space Invaders. Saviors or destroyers, it's just a matter of perspective. Ooh, this sounds so good. Let's jump right in and see what's going to happen. 3 a.m. Jack, get out of bed. Go away, Harry. It's a school night. Plus I'm exhausted. We were so late back from the video game arcade. I still can't believe Lisa beat us on Space Invaders. Why do they even still have that game? It's so old. Stop messaging and listen, Jack. Tom's camping tonight. Yep. His parents bought an RV last month. So what? He just sent me this from the lake. Oh my gosh. What is that? It's a spaceship, Jack. And Tom said it was heading towards them. I think we're being invaded. Very funny, Harry. I knew you loved that arcade game. Turn on your TV if you don't believe me. It's on the local news! Oh my gosh! OMG! It says it's happening all over the city! I don't want to worry you, but have you looked outside? I don't think I want to. I took this from my bedroom window! And there are two more of these things in the distance. There were reports of lights all over Seattle last week and Chicago the week before. Is this the end of the world? It could be. Or maybe the start of a new one? I'm waking up my mom and dad. They're not in bed. They're probably downstairs glued to the news like everyone else. They're not in the lounge either. The kitchen? I can't find them anywhere in the house! It's like in the Jimmy Neutron movie where all the parents got kidnapped by aliens? Maybe they went outside to look at the spaceships? Couldn't get dressed and look for myself. Hold on, Jack. I can see people outside in the street. They're all looking up at the saucer above the cinema car park. Are my parents there? Wait, let me look. I see Greg and Laura from school walking toward it. Mr. Price, the PE teacher. My mom and dad? It's impossible to tell. There's hundreds of people walking across the road. They're moving like a herd of cattle. Oh my gosh, they're all being like hypnotized by the aliens. Wait, I think I just spotted your mom. Is she okay? She's walking along with all the others. OMG. What? What's happening? The people in the cinema car park, they're being sucked into the sky! What do you mean? They're disappearing into the belly of the spacecraft! You mean they're being abducted? I don't know another word for it. What's happening on your street? I can see people coming out of their houses. So many of them are in their pajamas. They're all walking in the same direction. Toward the UFO. It's like the entire town is being drawn to them. Not quite the whole town, Harry. Well, it looks like the whole town from here. Then why aren't we walking towards them too? Harry, are you there? Lisa, have you seen what's happening? Of course I have. But you haven't been beamed up. Not yet. I've messaged everyone I know. But you're the only one who's messaged me back. Those things have taken everyone. Not quite everyone, Lisa. There's you, me, and Jack left. I'll invite him to the group. The Three Musketeers? I'm not sure we've got what it takes to save the universe. There must be something we can do. We can only hope that there is. Hi guys, can you believe this? We have to do something. I've already called the sheriff's office, all of the emergency service, the FBI, but no one's answering their phones. How did she get the FBI's number? Could it be because they're busy with the alien invasion? Maybe. Or there's a possibility that they've all been abducted. I can see the lights on the horizon, but it's too early for dawn. I don't think it's sunlight. I think it's fire. The ground just shook. There are explosions in the streets. What is happening? OMG, they're attacking us. Find some cover. The buildings are on fire. It's a full-scale assault. It's carnage out there, but they've already abducted everyone. Why are they still attacking us? Soon there'll be nothing left. Oh my gosh, this would be so scary. 01101011011. Wait, isn't this binary for dead? What is that? Is that binary code, Harry? Looks like it to me. Why are our phones picking up binary code? More to the point, who is sending it? The aliens? 01100011100010010011100. I can't handle the heat from all this fire. Where are you, Harry? I just entered a house and I'm hiding in the basement. Why would you hide in the basement if there are like fires everywhere? Is it safe? It's not on fire yet, but I can hear footsteps above me. Another survivor? I'll take a look. Be careful. Remember, the electricity is off across town. It's okay. I'm feeling my way through the dark. OMG. What is it? It's the invasion force! Oh my gosh, what? What? Get back to the basement! Yes, sir! Lisa, where are you? I'm in a shop doorway. I can see those things in the streets. There are so many of them. But I've been doing some research. You're such a nerd, Lisa. What could you possibly be researching at a time like this? Binary code. I'm downloading an app. I used it to translate the numbers we were sent. What did it say? I don't know if it was accurate. Just tell us already. It said, keep calm. Are you serious? Wait, I thought that was binary code for death. Alien spaceships are attacking. Our hometown is on fire. I'm just telling you what it said. Are they listening to us? 0010001. What does it say, Lisa? Give me a second. Aren't these the same numbers? It says, safe place. I don't trust this. The message says friend. Wait, so are they friendly aliens? How are we supposed to know where the safe place even is? The woods? I don't see any other option, guys. Okay, so that's our meeting point. How about the old cabin near the tiger swing? You mean the old scarecrow house? I take an old scarecrow over these alien invaders on any day of the week. Let's go! Zool. Who the frick is Zool? Hello, Earthlings. My universal translator is working again. How is this? Zool? I am a distant friend. How distant? Are we talking Seattle or Jupiter? Quite a bit further, actually. We are about 100 light years off. So you're our friend who's destroying our planet? Hey, I do not work for these tech heads. I merely hitched a ride. You're a stowaway? How have you survived? Hiding in the engine room and eating whatever food stuff they leave behind. Like what? Vitamin pills, plant extracts, lots of eggs. Chicken eggs? Is a chicken green with scales? Not even close. Gross! Stop talking about alien food. But it's not alien to me. To me, Earth food is disgusting. Did you know the ingredients of a berry burger? Wait, they went to the berry burger in the Hunter series. If you did not see that episode, that was so insane. You can check that up right there if you click the I. Enough with the chit-chat. What can we do to stop this invasion? It's not an invasion. Not like you think, anyway. Then what would you call it? Believe it or not, they are trying to save you. By setting our home on fire? It's a replanting of the world. One city at a time. Are these the same spaceships that were seen over Seattle and Chicago? I don't know the silly names you give your population hives. Let's cut to the chase. Why weren't we affected? Something in the three of you responded differently to their hypnosis technology. Have you done something out of the ordinary recently? Wait, we were all drawn to something last night. The retro arcade? I've never played Space Invaders in my life. But last night, I must have played 20 games at least. The visitors have always had a sense of humor. But don't worry. The human race will be back. When? When they've re-nourished the town. How long will this take? About 100 years or so. We'll be dead by then! Not at all. Time works differently from where we're from. What is that supposed to mean? It isn't supposed to mean anything. It is a fact. So what are we meant to do? My advice is simple. Stay in the forest. But it's starting to catch fire. The heat from the town is causing that. Why are you even helping us? You're just some stowaway. You have to trust me, kids. Stay where you are. You're close enough to the mothership, but far enough away from the pollutants of town. The forest is not a target of redesign. Try to sleep, and when you wake up, everything will be the same, just a little different. We will never sleep with all this going on. Look at your phones. Into my eyes. Ah, is he gonna hypnotize us? And relax. Ah! Oh,
Oh, I thought that was the end. I was like, excuse me?
Morning, Jack.
Mom?
I was getting worried. You went to bed so early yesterday. Just making sure you were awake. Are you coming downstairs? Your breakfast is ready.
What happened to you? Are you okay?
What do you mean, what happened?
The UFOs. Where did they take you?
UFOs? Are you still dreaming? I haven't been anywhere. It's you who went missing, remember?
What do you mean by that?
Are you sure you're okay, honey? You've been so tired since Mr. Price found you and your friends in the forest yesterday afternoon.
Harry and Lisa?
Who else? You had us all worried. I still wonder what you got up to.
I'm coming downstairs.
Okay, but remember to make your bed and open your curtains before you come down. It really is a beautiful day.
OMG. What is this place?
Oh my god, another new world? I'm sure you must have hit a bump in the head in those woods. It's Purity City, Jack. Wonderful as always. We've lived here for years, but it never gets old. Look at the glorious splendor. A perfect city in a perfect world. Now hurry down for breakfast. Your iguana eggs are getting cold.
Oh, no, no, that's the end. Oh my gosh, you guys. That was so good. That's so scary.
What if aliens come and they take away everything we know and they put us back, but we don't know that they did that?
Oh my gosh.
All right, you guys, I hope you enjoyed this crazy roller coaster of a ride of an episode. Make sure you subscribe and turn on your notifications so you know as soon as I post new videos. And you can also follow me on Instagram @GabriellaSkory to hang out in between uploads. Until then, I'll see you guys later. Bye!